I have the right to live with the freedom of who I am. And that was one of the biggest reasons which made me come out and become the first member of a royal family to come out openly as gay.
I remember falling to the floor. His arm went right around my neck in a way where I couldn't move, I couldn't breathe, and I started to black out.
I get it. I get that you don't like me. Let it go, dude. Like, what? I didn't get the words out of my mouth. In my face.
I felt safer much more back then than I do today. You know, they're wasting their minds by all this hatred and all this negative energy when there's so much beauty out there. Just being accepted, not tolerated, accepted. I'm here. I'm not going no place. We've always been here.
I am my son's voice. He is not here to be able to speak up and speak it for himself. And someone has to do it, and I'm his mom, and I will always do it. And not only will I do it for him, I will do it for anyone who feels like they can't use their voice.
Stonewall gives me the inspiration to be a better warrior.
I call him the Gandhi for our LGBTQ community.
The same. We don't all wear uniforms that makes us the same. We are an individual with minds and feelings and thoughts that are distinctly ours. And when we share it with others, as far as love is love and hate is hate, love will always conquer hate.
If this many people here are gay, it's not a real thing. You can't make someone feel invalid for being gay. It's not a choice. It's what they feel.
There's no map of life, but you have to know how to navigate it no matter what. So, you know what? Let's have a conversation.